Love is in the air. It's the run-up to St. Valentine's Day, and we're all hard at it. Calling in the favours, getting together all those romantic little extras, making sure we cash in on Cupid. Nothing is too much trouble. Everything is possible. But as the swan appears to glide gracefully through the water, the feet below are paddling furiously. It's like a beautiful and well-choreographed ballet. You want champagne and chocolates? We've got them. You want a top night in with your other half? We can certainly deliver the ingredients. You want music? One of the world's most breathtaking coloratura sopranos with an extended high range? No problem.
Oh, mio babbino caro, mi piace bello.
You want us to park our taste at the door? We'll grit our teeth and make sure you and your lovely lady have a night to remember. Even the most bizarre requests, a couple of lovebirds, can be accommodated. But surprises aren't always for the guests. Sometimes we also get them from nowhere, invariably turning our little cosy world completely on its head.
Hotel Babylon is a triumph of tacky style over non-existent content. If it's still here in a year, I'll eat the chef's hat, which is preferable to his a la carte.
Shit.
Worst I've ever read.
It's the worst he's ever written.
Didn't know anyone could be that rude. Morning, Charlie.
Morning, Anna.
Yeah, I've been taking cancellations all morning.
Take it you've all read this.
Good to see our shiny new PR's on top of her game.
Well, to be fair, Alexander Crawfield didn't tell the hotel he was coming in. Nobody spotted him in the restaurant.
I've had half the maitre d's in London calling up to crow.
All I'll say at the moment is it's nothing really to be worried about. Poor review.
One dreadful review.
One duff review from Mr. Crawfield really isn't the end of the world.
Just the end of people booking into our restaurant, which is rapidly resembling the Marie Celeste. Come Valentine's night tomorrow, it'll just be Gino and myself holding hands over an avocado mousse.
I've had worse evenings.
Sorry, but this is the one night that makes up for all the other crappy February nights in the dining room. It's Emily's job to have seen it come in. Hi, you stood there.
The last time Crawfield awarded a one-star review, that Asian fusion place in Chelsea closed within a week.
Hi. Sorry, I'm late. Odd. Have you seen this?
Yes.
Oh, good. Well, then let me get you up to speed with my thoughts about the chef problem.
Chef problem? I wasn't aware we had one.
When Alexander Crawfield says that our steak is as tough as a hoodie's trainer, we have a problem with the person who cooked the food.
Sous chef probably cooked it.
Well, then we have a problem with the person who allowed it to be served. Would you pass these around, please? So, I've been talking to a few people, and I think I have come up with a solution.
Really?
We bring in a celebrity chef with Michelin stars. The figures make sense. If you could all turn to page 2, please. This line is takings, and this is time. This is the Burlington. This is the Burlington after they hired Jacques Salaver. Takings went up over 65% over 2 months.
Where did you get all of this from?
Let's just say I have a friend. So, if we take away the money a celebrity chef earns for putting their name above the door, plus the 25% they get on all takings, and the 80,000 for a head chef to do the actual cooking while they're swanning around on TV, then our profit margin should look something like this. Sorry, it's still a bit rough around the edges.
Well, thank you, Emily, for your thoughts.
Thank you.
However, we already have a chef here that's been working here for 8 years.
And got the hotel out of many a tight spot.
Adam's a talented chef, and talented chefs don't lose it overnight.
Charlie, Adam's been losing it for months.
I'll be investigating what's happened, and I will have the situation under control. Is that understood?
Perfectly understood, Charlie.
Right, well, tomorrow is Valentine's Day, so let's forget about the reviews and pull out all the stops to make it a great one for the hotel. Thank you, everyone. Anna, could you stay behind a moment?
Yeah, please. very sweet of Her Royal Highness to offer us a box for the duration of the tournament, but I am afraid we're otherwise engaged. Please pass on our apologies to her private secretary.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning, madam. I believe you have a booking in the name of Hamilton?
Sir Ralph and Lady Hamilton.
In town for Valentine's Day?
Actually, no.
Ah, you're in the Hanging Garden suite. Your special requests are ready and waiting for you.
Excellent. If you'd just give us our key.
Oh, just one moment, madam. Do excuse me.
Of course. This week.
An evening's possibly after.
After.
Sir Ralph and Lady Hamilton are here.
Good. Excellent. Who?
Sir Ralph and Lady Hamilton. The computer said you wanted to be told when they arrived.
Yes. Of course I did, and you've done that. Thank you, Ben. Very good. And that's exactly what I was talking to Anna about.
Right.
Better get back to reception.
Charlie, what are you talking about?
Actually, I do want to talk to you about them. They're phenomenally well-connected and exactly the type of people I want at the hotel. Actually, they normally stay at the Arden. However, I want you to look after them and see to it that they have absolutely everything before they've even finished asking for it.
Really? Me?
I think you're ready for a little bit more responsibility. Seeing as how we work so well together.
You won't regret it. Oh, you can count on me.
Well, I hope so, because I am.
Okay.
60, madam. But you do not look a day over 42.
Sweet boy. The 60th birthday is Sir Ralph's.
Many happy returns, Sir Ralph.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you, Ben. I shall take over from here. Good morning, Lady Hamilton, Sir Ralph. I'm Anna Thornton-Wilton, Special Guest Relations Manager, and I shall be looking after you throughout your stay with us. I shall be organising your menus, booking your cars and beauty treatments, and liaising between you and our staff.
Wonderful.
Excellent.
Since when?
Since Charlie just asked me to, so back off. So if I could take you through the vulgarity that is swiping a credit card.
Oh, by the way, this is my son, Giles.
Oh, how do you do? And will you be joining your parents for dinner tomorrow evening?
Joining us? We can't get rid of the boy.
Is that your broomstick parked outside on a double yellow, Mother?
Oh,
I'm Charlie Edwards, the general manager.
How do you do? Mm-hmm.
Can I say what a pleasure it is to welcome you to Hotel Babylon?
Thank you. It's quite an establishment you have here.
Oh, thank you, sir.
The staff are charming.
Anything you want, Anna will get it for you.
Anything?
Within reason, of course.
Great, thank you very much. Thank you so much. That would be so absolutely brilliant. Yes, you're a lifesaver. And I promise you, you will love this place. Okay, will do. Bye.
Adam.
Oh, no, don't bring that rag in here.
You know we're going to have to talk about this.
There's nothing to talk about.
You are joking. The most feared restaurant critic in London has just royally kicked our ass.
It was a bad night.
No, that is the problem. It was an absolutely ordinary night. We rely on diners. There is no excuse.
I've got some problems at home, but I am trying to sort things out.
I want to hear that you're on top of the job. I want to hear that this is never going to happen again. Now, I'm under an immense amount of pressure to deliver like this hotel has never delivered before.
Okay, message received loud and clear, boss.
Taking a piss isn't going to help. Where are the Valentine's menus?
Yeah, I'm working on them.
Oh, come on. I asked you for them 3 days ago.
Charlie, give me a break.
Please stop talking to me like I'm your mate. I'm your manager.
Wasn't so long ago you came to me as a mate when you needed a 12-course tasting for the Japanese ambassador, on top of a last-minute wedding for 300 people.
Well, that was then and this is now.
Ah.
I really, really need you to take what I'm saying seriously.
Okay.
This review, it ruins business. It puts the hotel in a state of crisis. There's whispers of all sorts flying around upstairs. Now, I'll deal with that. But be under no illusion, the heat is most definitely on.
Have a romantic stay.
He's hoping.
Oh, it's nothing like dropping a bit of cash to get you in the mood.
She's only after one thing.
Really?
A ring. He's also only after one thing. Shame it isn't the same thing. Oh, nice to see someone's busy.
I'm managing 6 proposals, 3 anniversaries, and a golden wedding.
Oh, we're about as popular as a hosepipe banner at a wet t-shirt competition.
Really? How many bookings you got? 3!
Don't say it out loud, I might have to cry.
Good morning, how can I help you?
Hi there.
William Jones and Becky Shawcross.
Here we are. A double with, twin beds.
That's right.
Oh, okay.
We're abstainers.
Abstaining from
sex before marriage.
We're saving ourselves until we go down the aisle.
Love waits.
Of course it does. Room 235, on the second floor. The lift's over there. Have a quiet stay.
Peace be with you, brother.
And also with you.
Perfume.
If this is a code word, you have to tell me what it's for before you use it.
No. I just thought loving your position might know what the latest smell is out on the street. It's been ages since I bought anything.
Okay. For a bird?
A little bit more than a bird.
I spotted my ally. Someone beginning with A.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Leave it with me.
Emily, what can I do for you?
Tilio, I need a bottle of your finest bubble sent up to Sir Ralph and Lady Amelia in the Hanging Garden Suite. Pronto, Dino! Oh my God, it's...
Otto Clark.
What's he doing here?
Otto Clark, what a pleasure it is to see you. How can I help you?
I have a meeting with Emily James and someone called Charlie Edwards.
I can't believe that you've done this.
Charlie, when are you going to realise that I'm not the enemy? Otto Clark single-handedly put the Chesterton back on the map.
I wasn't aware we were off the map.
Well, we're not off the map, exactly. But we're hardly a visible destination. Publicity follows Otto around like wags at a football match. I thought you should meet him. Which is why I asked him to drop by.
The cavalry, as they say in horsey circles, has arrived. You must be Charlie.
Otto Clark.
You've probably seen me talking bollocks on the telly, but don't be fooled, I can actually cook.
Your reputation precedes you, of course.
Well, the amount I pay my publicist, I should hope so.
I'm afraid you've had a wasted journey, Mr. Clark. I already have an executive chef.
Yes, he's the talk of the town.
I don't think that's fair.
Charlie, if only you try
something. Thank you, Emily. I really don't need another chef, Otto. Adam Price is excellent at his job.
Yes. Now, if you're not interested in turning this place around, having the critics salivating around the block for a table, well, then I can only say I admire your loyalty. And this Adam Price is a lucky chap to have it. Arrivederci, sweetheart. Maybe next time.
Yeah, a cook-off.
What?
Otto's Valentine's Day menu against Adam's. The best man gets the job.
I'm sure Mr. Clark has better things to do with his time.
On the contrary. I'm a sucker for a competition.
You're joking.
Look at his face. You don't need me. You will eat my food, Charlie, swiftly followed by your words.
Rose's room, 323, and Lily's for 360.
Oh, Jesus, look. Phone stars. 7 o'clock.
Huh?
Yeah. Reception. The guy looks like a tandoori dish and the girl with the spray-on microscope.
You sad old sexist. Just because a girl has tits and a tan, you think she works in porn?
I don't think, Jackie. I know.
These days, porn is a suburban housewife being plumbed by a plumber on a Drayland sofa.
I had no idea you were such an aficionado.
Just because I'm a single mum doesn't mean all my evenings are bubble baths and bedtime stories.
Have you seen the porn stars?
Okay, who thinks they're porn stars? They are porn stars.
You two are pathetic. They look nothing like sex industry workers.
Porn stars.
Hey, if those two are not taking photos of each other within 5 minutes, I will... buy a black leather cap, you know, with studs around the brim, and eat it.
Yeah, the three of us tomorrow night.
Champagne.
How very kind.
Now, also...
Dom Perignon 96.
Ooh, how delicious. Do stay for a glass.
Well, I'm afraid I'm on duty. But also...
Giles, pour Anna a glass of this wonderful champagne.
Oh, of course.
Well, if you insist.
Try not to let the bubbles get up your nose.
Now, I also took the liberty of ringing the Arden where you usually stay.
Oh, thank you. Wonderful hotel, but for its spa. They claim their deep-cleansing mud heralds from the Dead Sea, but I know for a fact it comes from a hole in the ground on the outskirts of Coventry.
Well, they told me that you have a dust allergy, so I wondered if you'd prefer bedding made of amicore pure fibres.
That sounds perfect, thank you.
You're wasted on reception.
Yes, I am. I also wanted to check that you received the gifts that you pre-ordered.
Right down to the velvet box of Asprey's goodies.
I can hear you, Amelia. She's going to ruin my surprise.
Well, I'm glad that everything's to your satisfaction.
Such a treasure. Thornton Wilton, you say? Not connected to the Surrey Thornton Wiltons by any chance?
Well, yes, as you happen to mention it.
I knew it. Do you see Bunny frequently?
Bunny? It's funny you should say that because we occasionally holiday in the Seychelles together.
How marvellous.
You both adore to snorkel. Bunny can hold her breath for up to 6 minutes, whereas I can only manage a minute and a half.
Remarkable.
1 year, I got my foot trapped in a giant clam.
No! You idiot!
Oh!
Pick him up!
Susan.
What are we doing here exactly?
Only that there is, after all, something as a free lunch.
We're here to lend Adam moral support and at the same time hope that flesh bastard off the telly screws up.
The smart money's on Upton, because you're always doing the Richard and the Judy.
Well, I'm supporting Adam, of course. How about you?
I'm supporting whoever make the restaurant full and bring heavy tippers to my bar.
Here, here. Should we start?
Yes. Oh, that looks wonderful.
Okay, talk me through this.
Well, we've got prawns poached in absinthe, in baskets of a parsnip rosti with a tomato and cucumber coulis, and a salmon timbal salad.
Sounds interesting. Otto?
It's a tuna carpaccio.
Anything else?
With ingredients this good, anything else would be superfluous.
Oh, absolutely. Gorgeous.
Well, salmon fillet, pan fried in cognac, with dill and butter jus, and croquet potatoes, and pickled beetroot compote.
Salmon looks good. I'm a big fan of compote.
This, as you're probably aware, is my signature dish. Lobster ravioli with a foie gras mousseline sauce.
It's very famous and utterly delicious.
Salmon's good.
So filling.
Oh, that's good.
Oh,
actually, that's very good.
Both look great.
I think someone opened and slammed closed the oven door while Mum was cooking.
What is that meant to be?
It's a chocolate pot. It tastes better than it looks.
I'm sure. And yours, Otto, I can tell on sight, is a tarte au citron.
The lemons were flown in from Sicily this morning.
I can smell the groves from here. Gorgeous. Charlie, would you like to do the honours?
Sure.
Well? Chocolatey? And now Otto's.
I must say, I'm really not a pudding type person. That is amazing. That is unbelievable. You should get stuck into that.
I have to say that's good.
Oh, that should be legal. So, what do you think of Otto's menu?
As expected. Superb.
Good enough for tomorrow night.
Perhaps.
Eight years he's given this place.
It's only a question of business.
Oh, Charlie would have said it was a question of loyalty.
Well done, darling. You're a marvellous.
I'm sorry, Adam.
Yes, so am I. So is my wife, my children, and my bank manager.
I'm not asking you to leave. I'm saying stay and be Otto's number two. I need someone who can manage the day-to-day. You know the kitchens, the team know you.
Fine, fine.
It is a demotion, I understand that you've...
Spare me the concerned boss's spiel, okay? I said fine. Fine means you don't have to keep talking at me. Fine means I'll eat shit, if that's what you want. So long as you shut the hell up.
Porno stars are actually filming upstairs in the room.
How many times do I have to say it? They're not porn stars.
But if they are, and Johnny finds out that they are filming, it's going to be extremely pissed off.
So
I think I should do some special undercover Gina operation to find out if they actually are in the bang bang business.
What undercover operation?
Research on the computer.
By which you mean watching lots and lots of porn till you recognise them?
Yeah, no, but I'm prepared to do it for the name of the hotel.
Right. Oh, Anna, the pillows in the suite. Yes, would you like some more? No, they're filled with duck feathers. Yes, Sir Ralph can only sleep on goose. Goose, right, okay, I'll see to that straight away. Thank you. Oh, do sit down a moment. Giles. Thanks.
You know, I suddenly remembered. Bunny Thornton Wilton was there when I first met Sir Ralph.
Really?
Yes. We'd broken down by the side of the road, so I tried flagging down some assistance. Suddenly, a jaguar pulled onto the hard shoulder, and out stepped Sir Ralph, lithe as a panther. Bunny practically creamed herself.
Yes, well, Bunny always has been a bit of a creamer.
Thousands drove by, but Ralph stopped. Within minutes, he had changed my tyre and my life. 6 weeks later, we were wed.
I came along almost 9 months to the day.
Well, that can happen when you mix Monsieur Verve and Clicquot with a four-poster bed in a French chateau.
Pavlov's dog's got nothing on that girl when it comes to a whiff of money and class.
So did you not think of having any more children?
Oh, I'd have loved more. But after Giles, Sir Ralph's sperm count plunged through the floor, and that was that. Sorry.
Don't be. I proved more than a handful.
Oh, dear.
Allow me.
Oh, thank you.
Good evening, Lady Hamilton.
Oh.
I trust everything's to your satisfaction.
Difficult to imagine how it could be more so.
Anna. I think you should get back behind reception. Ben's rushed off his feet.
I thought you wanted me to look...
Now.
Okay. Sorry, excuse me a moment, of course.
If there's anything else that you need during the duration of your stay, please do not hesitate to contact me.
Of course, we will. Thank you.
See, I told you they were filming themselves. It's live. I've been watching the webs.
Have you been doing this all night?
Yeah, it's been difficult, but, you know, for the good of the hotel.
Right. Gina, we all know that's not a broken arm. It's a sprained wrist.
I'm right-handed.
I knew the spray tan Tucson were dodgy as soon as I saw him. Can we tell it's definitely their room?
It's difficult to say. The camera's way too... Way, way too close.
This is not good.
Of course it's not good. The way he's put his... That is his foot, isn't it?
Like, the last thing we need right now is to be known as the Porn Hotel. Bloody hell.
The reverse cowgirl position. A position to be attempted only by the Berry Berry Bandy.
Oh, so it has a name?
They all have names.
We need one of them to take their masks off so we can be absolutely certain it's them.
Well, who needs faces when the body art tells you everything you need to know?
Boys, boys, boys.
Oh, it's not what it looks.
Anna, we would very much like to have breakfast in our room tomorrow morning. Anna?
Oh, sorry.
Everything all right?
Yes, no, everything's great. You want breakfast in your room tomorrow
at... In my experience, a face like that is caused by one of two things. Either a man or a man.
One moment seeming absolutely lovely, the next being a complete and utter bugger. But the thing
is... You don't know what you did to change things. And do you know why?
Why?
Because you didn't do anything. It isn't you. Because in the short time we've spent together, I can see you're open, kind, and very, very lovely.
Yes, well, all I need now is a car which to break down on the M25 so I can find my own Sir Ralph.
Look, why don't you help me on my shopping trip tomorrow? My monthly splurge on Sir Ralph's account.
I couldn't.
If I don't spend it, he'll only have to give it to the tax man.
Oh, I can't have that.
Of course not.
Oh, boss, you know that perfume you asked me about earlier? Oh, I managed to find this very
lovely. Forget about it. It doesn't look like I'm going to be needing it after all.
What, you've gone off already?
Listen, I want you to make that sound better. It's all right.
Attention, please. Good morning, everyone. My name is Otto Clark.
And for reasons I think we're all aware, I am your new executive chef. Do not make the mistake that in my kitchen I am the genial tit you have seen on the goggle box. I do the genial tit on the goggle box for the profile it brings my restaurants. Full stop. I am all about the food and all about business. One begats the other, and both of them begot me my Michelin stars. My staff tend to call me the assassin, and if I see that you are no damn good, I will come up behind you and you'll be asked to get your things and leave. So, if you are feeling shit, tell me. If you are in the shit, tell me. If you are shit, well then do us both a favour and slip away now before I find you out. Now, I have taken the liberty of ordering us some new whites. So, find a set that fits quickly, because we have less than 12 hours to turn disaster into triumph. To do that, I need all hands on deck and all egos, except mine, left at the door. I'm sorry, did someone speak?
Yes, sir.
Better, right. Let's get cooking.
So, he's here already?
Arrived this morning.
I'm the biggest penis substitute I've ever seen.
Who cares? Word's out already. My phone's dripping with bookings.
Happy Valentine's Day, everyone.
Thank you very much.
Cards from me to you.
Don't say this the wrong way, Emily, but aren't Valentine's cards supposed to be anonymous?
Well, they are if they're serious, but this is just a bit of fun. Fun, guys, to elicit smiling. Very popular with the happy.
Well, I'm happy because I have a secret admirer. I have the evidence here.
So which poor, deluded, presumably blind female sent you that?
I have a sneak feeling that it is the new sexy chambermaid, eh?
Who? Katya?
She's fit, eh?
She's a lesbian.
Jackie, did you get any cards?
Just one, but it did come with these.
Oh, wow.
Anna? No. No, not yet.
Charlie?
Ooh, look. Here's one without a stamp. Ooh, and kisses.
Come on, who's that from?
No idea. Thank you.
Oh, bit of news. I've managed to persuade Alexander Crawford to come back and give the restaurant another shot.
What? When?
Tonight.
Tonight?
Talk about piling on the pressure.
Well, Alexander Crawford wrote us into this mess. We make damn sure he gets everything he needs to write us out.
Looks like it's all hands to the pump, then.
Well, my hands are reserved for carrying shopping.
What shopping?
Lady Amelia asked me to accompany her on a spree, is that okay?
Giles.
I don't think so. Can I go?
Enjoy.
Great.
Look, I know it's the shortest of short notices, but I have absolute faith that Otto can pull this off.
Well, with less than 12 hours to prepare and a kitchen full of lags he's never worked with before, buckle yourselves in, boys and girls, because we're in for a shitstorm.
Why are these still here when they haven't been fresh since last Saturday?
Oh, God's sake, Adam.
You know as well as I do, these need to be cleaned every week. Christ, somebody just moved.
That was for six people, wasn't it?
Actually, could you just hold for 1 second?
Thank you very much.
Yes, of course. Is that a table for two? I'm afraid I can use it.
It's curdled. So bin it and start again.
Yes, that was a table for six. Yes, that's confirmed. Great. Fine. And your name?
This is for you. What? For all your help, I insist. Here.
Oh, Lady Amelia.
Giles is a handsome chap, but necklaces really aren't his thing.
Oh, it's adorable.
As are you.
But I can't accept it.
Anna.
No, as much as I would love to, it would be totally unprofessional, but thank you so much for the thought.
You really are quite a remarkable little thing, aren't you?
It's nice that someone notices. Thank you. Then.
Where next?
Cocktails.
Great.
Do these say Otto Clark?
No, they say inoffensive modernism.
Change them.
To what?
Well, something better, obviously.
More inoffensive or more modern?
I think we should put Alexander Crawford in the middle.
No, this will be next to that boring bloke from the Sunday Times. The corner is much better.
Oh, no. No, that's near the kitchen. He hates to sit near the kitchen. Didn't you know that?
In a couple of hours, people are going to be queuing up to eat here. God knows I'm grateful to you for that, Emily. But I am the restaurant manager, while you are PR. I'll stay out of your photo shoots if you stay out of my restaurant.
Mm.
Excuse me, can you tell me where I can find the nearest drugstore? I'm looking for some baby oil.
Baby oil?
Yeah, you know, baby oil.
Yeah, I know what baby oil is for.
Vaseline will be equally.
Oh, my God. Jackie, hi. Can I borrow you for a second, please?
Yeah.
Mr. Arden here would like some baby oil and Vaseline.
Or Vaseline.
And please move this couple away from Christians now.
Let me direct you to the nearest chemist. It's probably best if I step outside.
Can I be of any help?
We're just interested in the time of the evening service at St. George's, Hanover Square.
Of course you will. I'll find out and have the details sent straight up to you.
Bless you.
Bless you.
Phew.
I see you two have been pushing the materialist envelope.
I won't tell you how much I've spent. I bought Anna a beautiful necklace, but she won't accept it.
Oh, it fair restores my withering faith in human nature.
Anna, why don't you join us for a drink before dinner this evening?
Oh, no, I wouldn't want to intrude.
Oh, stop that. Come at 7. Don't be late.
Oh, okay.
Pull this off, it'll be a miracle.
Oh, ye of little faith.
How's it all going?
Swimming along. We're one stroke ahead of calamity, but we're getting there.
Excellent. Keep up the good work.
It's the fourth time you tasted it.
And I'll continue to do so until you get it right.
It's perfect.
Veal has a delicate flavour, which you have completely swamped.
Box.
You've over-seasoned it. It's a tendency of chefs who've lost the plot.
I have not lost the plot. I've just hit...
You had your chance, and you blew it. Now I've got 175 covers coming through a door with my name over it.
Yeah, and I know it.
Your job is to do as I tell you, not to burn with resentment while you wallow in self-pity. Yes?
Yes.
Yes, chef.
Screw you.
Hello?
I trust he's not going to be taking business calls all night.
It being Valentine's, nice and everything.
Fingers crossed it's a rock the size of Gibraltar. action stations, Crawfield is in the building. Repeat, Crawfield is in the building.
Hello?
He's here.
I'm on my way. Ring Charlie and let him know.
Pleasure to have your company again, Mr. Crawfield. If there is anything you require, anything at all, you can be assured of my personal attention at all times.
Just a seat and a menu will be sufficient for now.
Yes, of course.
Good evening, Mr. Crawfield. Thank you for coming back so swiftly and giving us an opportunity to correct what I personally feel was an erroneous first impression.
Let's hope your golden boy can spin a little magic onto your plates. Two disgusting dinners in a row and I'll savage you so hard you won't be able to flog so much as a packet of crisps.
Really?
I'm sure you will find our menu is much improved.
Well, genius in the kitchen must be matched by style on the restaurant floor. As I remember last time the service was about as slick as dry toast.
May I take your coats? If you'd like to come this way. Would this table suit?
I think that one looks a little more discreet.
Alexander's put on show all the time. It's such a bore.
Of course.
Alexander, how are we tonight?
All the better for seeing you. Christ must be hugging himself with glee to have someone of your calibre.
I hope you've left your fangs in a little box at home.
Always keep a spare set on me. One never knows quite how tough the filet mignon will be.
Your menu, madam. Sir, excuse me.
You must try the lobster ravioli.
Oh, anything would be better than the roadkill I had last week.
Oh, Alexander, you promised to be nice.
You only promised to try.
That's less a raviolo and more a lady's handbag. I want them nice and tight.
Yes, chef.
Tim, what are you doing?
Tasting, chef.
If it's the second time, it's not tasting, it's eating the profits. Now swallow and get back to work.
Ooh.
And that goes for all of you.
Yes, sir.
Unbelievable.
Nice. Why are you still here?
One has been invited for preprandial drinks with Sir Ralph and Lady Amelia.
Ooh, lucky old one.
But not in my official capacity.
you, but as a family friend, because they obviously recognise good breeding.
You know, Gina and Tony can recognise breeding. Well, at least they can certainly recognise people trying to breed.
It's for you.
Going somewhere nice?
I've got drinks with the Hamiltons.
Well, probably after it pays off.
What do you mean?
Nothing. Nothing at all. OK, we've got 9 tables seated in Cork Hall, ready and waiting for your very best shot.
Everything's under control. To do with the head chef, though.
Where is it?
No idea. Sulky bastard minced off about an hour ago.
How come?
Why do people walk away? Because they can't face the truth.
Caulfield's table wants 1 lobster ravioli to start and 1 tuna carpaccio.
I want 1 lobster and 1 tuna. I want them quick and I want them to die for.
Yes, yes.
Jesus Christ, where's he going?
Sir, chef, it's the lobster.
You mean it's the lobster? How do you know it's the lobster?
It's the only thing I've eaten all day, chef. I'm sweating hot and cold with an arse like a tap.
Seafood poisoning.
I happen to be off if it was alive at 2 o'clock this afternoon. Lobster?
Yes, chef.
Bloody disaster. Little shit.
He's used the lobster that should have been chucked 3 days ago.
Oh, hold on a second.
He's sabotaged me, Charlie. Your grill jockey wants to take me and you and this entire hotel down with him.
James.
Will be worth the wait.
God Almighty could zap through his signature dish and it wouldn't be worth this wait.
In case you need telling, we are now officially in the shit. 3 men down and 7 minutes to get these dishes out before the customers start walking. This is where you earn your testicles, gentlemen.
Yes, sir.
You, sauce. You, new lobster. Have you ever made pasta?
Yeah.
From scratch?
A couple of times.
You, show him how.
Yes, sir.
Hello?
All that glisters is not gold, except pure gold.
Stay pure, sweet Anna. Lady A.
Very much.
Thank you. Come again soon.
Who knows? We may well do that.
All set, Daddy?
Do me a favour, bun it. Yeah.
Oh, I think I can help you with that.
Well, can't you two wait?
You know your trouble, Derek. You worry too much about appearances.
Oh, bloody hell.
Who?
Hamilton.
Just got this for seeing them off. Why?
Why? Why? Because I think they've cleaned us out, that's why. Their room is empty. Everything they had to wash in the room has gone. All the shopping, everything. All the credit cards. Oh, oh my God. How am I going to tell Charlie? Give me that.
Have you heard the rumour that Jacques Salavert has checked into rehab? Please stay.
I said rare.
How much longer?
Only there. Go. Go.
Running.
Your starter, sir.
Thank you.
madam. And I am terribly sorry for the delay.
Perhaps it was worth the wait. How's your Carpaccio?
Quite wonderful.
Thank you.
You were just going to laugh and laugh when I tell you how the Hamiltons are not the Hamiltons and how they ripped off the hotel to the tune of approximately £45,000. Ripped off the hotel to the tune of approximately £45,000. See, you're not laughing.
How?
Everything they bought during their stay, they had charged their room, and they've packed their bags and they've done a runner. Oh, they did leave this, though. Lady Amelia wanted me to have it, but I said that I didn't want it. I think it's worth £4,000.
Oh, excellent. So I've only got to explain to the board why I need to write off £41,000.
Well, actually, they tipped in for floating their car, so it's £40,150.
You checked their card?
Yeah, but presumably it was closed shortly before we swiped it. Now it's blocked.
Didn't you notice anything suspicious?
Well, no, because they were professional con artists, Charlie. I was conned.
Or were you so taken in by Giles that you didn't look further than his pedigree?
You told me to look after them. I was working.
Working it, more like.
Screw you.
He likes it. He likes it. He bloody likes it. Crawfield likes us.
It's great, James. Really great.
You'd be amazed how many hankers I'll get through on Valentine's.
I feel like such an idiot.
Call your girlfriends up for a night out tomorrow. Spray yourself with this and celebrate being single. Because I've a very strong suspicion it won't be for very long. That's right. Leak all over your Uncle Tony.
I want to thank you for your help.
Mate, thanks for mine. I've seen a lot of stuff in this business, believe me, but I've never seen anyone coming back from the brink like that.
Well, Emily said it would be a challenge, and it was.
Thank Christ you're up to it.
Some are, some are not.
No news on Evan then?
I haven't seen it.
Chef, have you got your big carver?
What?
Your big chopper's not here. You don't think he's got on top of himself, do you?
Well, after what he did to my lobster, I wouldn't complain if he did.
That's all. That's a joke.
That's your choice, Charlie.
Shit, well, he could be anywhere. Well, we better start looking for him then.
Where's Otto? Crawfield is about to leave, and we have to take a photo.
It is. The Wicked Witch of the North, South, East and West.
I know.
I'm in here.
What the hell?
He's been drinking.
I'm so sorry about the ravioli, Otto. We stopped them going out.
Shame. Adam.
Oh, let him.
Shut up, Otto.
I've lost everything, Charlie. My job, my wife, kids.
Oh, God, Charlie.
Adam. Otto really could have done with you in there tonight. You've had a bit of bad luck, but you're a good chef, and this hotel needs good chefs.
I'm good. He's better.
All right, he's better. So what? You think I'm not aware that I'm working under the shadow of more experienced managers than me? It spurs me on to be as good as them, and maybe even one day better.
I don't know what to do.
Come here. Now listen, I never sacked you. I'm not going to. I just need you to take a little bit of time out to get your head together. And when you're better, the kitchen's here, the place for you.
We are so sorry. We got a little held up.
One way of putting it. Otto Clark.
Can I just say what a genuinely delicious meal that was?
Thank you. Coming from you, that means a great deal to me.
And you, darling, are something else.
Thank you.
Shall we?
Thank you for this.
Anything for my gorgeous goddaughter?
Are you sure this is the room?
Definitely. Listen.
OK, well, we've rumbled them, but evidence is vital.
Okay, we have to catch them, Andy.
Catch who at what?
Well, you mind keeping your voice down? Those two that you swore were not sex industry workers making porn on the other side of this door. Listen.
I can't hear anything. 20 quid, says you're wrong.
Make it 15, you've got a bet.
Done.
I've had a tougher time taking sweets from a baby.
Absolutely sure about this, Tony.
Have you got that 50 quid on you, Jackie? Why does it always have to be me?
Hey, I would love to do it, eh? But unfortunately, my arm. Anyway, you're the youngest, the smallest, and the weakest.
Oh, well, I'm not swinging down. I want to be lowered by my feet.
Come on, stop whining like a little girl dog. Jump.
Tino, Tony, Jackie! I cannot believe I didn't know that it was a bodybuilding convention at Earl's Court.
It's your job to know these things, Tony. Don't tell me standards are slipping.
Haven't you heard? Smugness is a very unattractive quality in a woman.
You call yourself a five-star hotel?
It's a disgrace.
Sir, madam, please accept my apology on behalf of the hotel.
Whereas humble pie is exactly what I look for in a man.
You are the worst winner I've ever come across.
Well, if you'd listened to me in the first place.
You knew all along, didn't you? How did you know?
I don't know, Tony. Call it common sense. Call it a woman's intuition.
I call it a rip-off.
Cashing in on Cupid is exhausting work. The romantic illusion punters pay for takes it out of us. Sometimes the tricks we pull to create and maintain your fantasy come at a price. Passing off romance as love and vice versa. Making you think it's going to be hearts and flowers all the way. The cold truth is that there are so many things that can come between you and a real happy ending.
I'm sorry.
They were professionals, Charlie.
I know.
You didn't spot them either.
If I wasn't so busy getting jealous, I might have. I'm sorry.
This is too difficult. You, me, this place, will we, won't we? It's making me unhappy, and I'm a happy person. So I'm going to hand in my resignation tomorrow morning.
Well, I won't accept it.
I don't really have a choice. Now, that I didn't expect.
I agree. It certainly gives a new meaning to the words Sunday service.
The Lord really does move in mysterious ways.
So you're stalking me now, is that it?
I know which way you walk home. I took a shortcut.
Johnny.
As far as the insurance is concerned, then, we'll just say that they took it with them. You deserve it. And Alan is happy. Just as I thought, you look stunning.
Stern is the heiress to the Stern fortune, and Earl Archer's a multimillionaire, and I secured their wedding at Hotel Babylon this weekend. Does it get any better than that?
Ni cojones.
To those of you about to diet, I salute you.
What's he got that I haven't worth?
All my secrets are in here, Gino.
You ate your whole life your big day, and it has to be perfect, doesn't it?
Of course.
Doesn't exactly take a genius to work out what's happened.
Well, that's good news for you then, isn't it, Tony?
I want to be part of a team, and from what I can see, this is the best team in London. Go, good!